friendly, familiar face should always be down here in a big city like this. It was. He had no family, no friends, nothing worth giving away, but he had his journal, and he wrote in it during the end of his time here. Little did I know, he was writing letters. He left one on that table. Let me go get it. I kept it behind the counter for months, hoping to give it back if he ever returned. But he never did. And I came across it again one holiday when I was late cleaning. And I read it.
What was in it?
The contents of the letter changed my life. And I hope it helps you to rethink your situation. Read all. No skipping.
Will you read it to me?
Yeah. You should take notes, too.
Don't be rude.
Just listen.
This illness was invisible, written off as stress or some shit isn't killed that thing. What a life. Live, work, and spend the rest of my time with my ass on a couch, watching whatever new groundbreaking show was on. No emotion. The only real connection I had was to the nicotine that poisoned my body. What body? There's no body left to poison me. Just cold, hard cancer. I had goals, dreams in this body. But I fell in love. The relationship was abusive. Nothing but abuse. I always used to think that I was the one that abused the nicotine. When in reality, it was the nicotine that abused me. A few inches of paper, tar, fire, and nicotine. The four elements of my demise. Living with this black disease flooding inside me isn't living. I'm watching myself die! Truly is what this point was. But life led me to the underworld. Not the punchline, to nature's cruel joke. Life is a tale told by an idiot. Full of sound and fury signifying nothing. I never understood the meaning of those lines until I got my test results back. But I have to disagree with Macbeth, though. Because life is not meaningless. No. Life is a gift. And it should not be wasted. We should be out there, chasing our bright futures and not living through scripted drama on screens. There is so much left to explore and experience. Death comes for us all. So burn. Burn so bright that death won't dampen the life inside of you. Regret is not a word I should use, because I let myself down this road. I regret so much. I regret never being a parent. I regret never leaving this city. I even regret not trying my old neighbor's peach cobbler. Not even once. I don't regret coming into this cafe, though, in which I'm attempting to leave something behind. I don't know what it is. A warning? Inspiration? Take it as you will. But please, take it. Read my story. Share it. Live your life to the fullest before your flame get snuffed. I dream the dream of times gone by. Thank you. so different.